I will ask permission from my Sheikh, Sheikh Muhammad Nazim Adil Al-Haqqani. May Allah give him long life.
Amen.
May Allah not only give him long life, but life that all full of health and happiness.
Amen.
And to be away from tyrant people.
Amen.
To be away from people who are trying to harm him indirectly or directly.
Amen.
And may Allah give him life that he can take care of all of us.
Amen.
Because his life is our barakah.
Amen.
His life is our life. His life is our spirit and soul. His life is our energy. His life is our happiness. His life is everything for us that guide us and direct us. And those who are being guided and directed are going to be rewarded in dunya and akhirah. And those who are harming him directly or indirectly are going to suffer dunya and akhirah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Holy Quran mentioned Surah Al-Munafiqun. And you know that surah, and I will try to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mentioned Surah Al-Munafiqun to give us something to understand in order that we will not fall into the problems that many other people went into it. And that surah is describing for us the situation that we are in. And it's okay. The English, okay. It's better translation.
منافق.
سورة 63. There are two kinds of people, of tyrants. Tyrants people. One group of tyrants, you know that they are your enemy. There are tyrants, you know they are your enemy. And you get away from them. But there are tyrants who are wearing the same what you are wearing, dressing the same what you are dressing, and saying that they are Muslim in order that you will be falling in the trap, in their trap. In order that they will be able to harm directly and indirectly, and these people, either they are from common Muslims, or they are from the same group of spiritual people who are following a guy like Maulana Sheikh Nazim's guidance. I want to thank Haji Jawdat today that he gave us the chance to speak here. Haji Jawdat, thank you very much.
I should know better. I didn't know.
It was surprising, quickly.
Is it?
Thank yeah. I called today Haider and I said I'm coming here.
MashaAllah. All right.
So that there are tyrants, as I said, that you know they are your enemy, you don't care for them. They are not Muslim, so you don't want to fight with them, because we are living, we have to live there. Allah said no compulsory in Islam, there is no, you cannot force anyone. They like to be Muslim, welcome. They don't like to be Muslim, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take care of them, will take care of us. But you know the distance, you can build bridges with them, you can negotiate with them, you speak with them, you integrate in their system, because you are part of the country. And Allah said, أَطِيعُوا اللَّهُ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولُ وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ. Obey Allah, obey Prophet, and obey those who are on authority. And they are on authority, we have to obey them. They are Muslim or not Muslim, we have to obey them. They are our authority, they are the government, we have to follow the government in every way. You cannot say, I like this, I follow them, I don't like this, I come against them. Whatever laws they put, you have to follow. And we are like that. This is what our Sheikh taught us, this is what Maulana Sheikh Nazim taught us, this is what Grand Sheikh Abu Bakr Faiz Dastani taught us, this is what Prophet taught us. I knew Maulana Sheikh Nazim since 1957, when I was 12 years of age. I'm now 60, I know Maulana Sheikh since 48 years. Not 1 year or 2 years or 5 years or 10 years. And I know who stabs Maulana in his back and who doesn't stab Maulana Sheikh in his back. It's not something that is hidden from me. So, the other group of tyrants, those who are, you don't know them, because they speak the same way, they eat the same way, they talk the same way, they pray the same way, but they are, Allah described them in Surah Al-Munafiqun, they are the worst. إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرَكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. Allah said, Munafiqun are the hypocrites, that they say something on their tongues, but in their hearts, they have something else. What he said, they are in the lowest and bottom of hellfire. They are in the lowest way, in the lowest degree of hellfire. إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرَكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ. In the lowest. And who is in the lowest? Munafiqun. So might be the not Munafiqun, the non-Muslim might be higher in level. The Munafiqun are worse. Because you don't know what kind of way they are. They don't tell you. And of two kinds, as I said, one kind that all of us we know, the Wahhabi kind, already known, that they are trying to brainwash the whole Muslim community and destroy the love of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and destroy the love of Awliya. And they did their best through their literatures and through their money, through their businesses, through their oil, to destroy the name of Muslims and to hijack the voice of Islam and Muslims. Everyone knows that. That's for the common Muslim at large. Allah said, إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ ذَكَرٍ وَأُنْثَى وَجَعَلْنَاكُمْ شُعُوبًا وَقَبَائِلَ لِتَعَارَفُوا إِنَّ أَكْرَمَكُمْ عِنْدَ اللَّهِ أَتْقَاكُمْ. Allah said in Holy Quran, we have made you male and female. We have created you from male and female. And we made you nation and tribes to know each other. The best among you are the righteous one. And Allah said, وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا. Hold tight to the rope of Allah and don't separate. This Wahhabi came and they separate us. Why they separate us? To hijack the voice of the Muslim and to speak on behalf of whole Muslims. To show that they are the only one that they are in contact, always relationship. They are the spokesmen of the Muslims. They are the spokesmen of their leaders. They are the spokesmen of the highest authority of the Wahhabi sect or cult, who is Abdul Aziz bin Baz, who died recently. Everything they relate to him, they say, oh, he said this, he said this, he said that, he said this, he said that, follow. Everyone of Muslim, like sheep, they follow. Is that? Allah described them munafiqun, will be coming. The others, which we have many tariqats. How many tariqats do you have?
40.
We have 41 tariqats. There is 41 tariqats. 40 tariqats coming from Sayyidina Ali. One tariqah coming from Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq, passing through Ja'far al-Sadiq, connecting with Sayyidina Ali. So it is coming from both sides. And this is the Naqshbandi tariqah that you are following. It's coming from two sides. From Sayyidina Ali, where Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَنَا مَدِينَةُ الْعِلْمِ وَعَلِيٌّ بَابُهَا. I am the city of knowledge, and Ali is the door. Means, the meaning or the understanding of that is, one time Sayyidina Ali had, his eye was hurt in one of the battles that was taking place. And Sayyidina Ali was in the tent, cannot fight because his eye is... So there was a fighter asking for Ali. And Prophet ﷺ didn't want Sayyidina Ali to come and fight, because in the old time, one against one at the beginning of the war, before it becomes fighting each other, they went one after one in front of one. We call it in Arabic Mubaraza. Challenging. Or one against one. A duel?
Duel.
Not duel. So, that man, Prophet sent someone, that man was strong, is a wrestler, enemy. He killed that man. Another one, he killed him. So then Sayyidina Ali came to Prophet, Ya Rasulallah, let me go after him. He took from his holy saliva and put on his eye, and it became as it was before. And he went fighting him one way this way, one way that way. He threw him on the floor. And that time when you throw someone on the floor, finish, he surrender, you can kill him. So that man, who was thrown on the floor, the wrestler of the enemy, with all his hate, he made a big spit and spit in the face of Sayyidina Ali. What Sayyidina Ali did? He left the sword, he threw the sword, he said, I'm not killing you anymore. He said, no, come, it's finished. You have to kill me. He said, no, I'm not killing you anymore. I'm not doing anything. Come and do, I'm not doing. Why? He said, because before I was killing you, I was fighting with you for Allah's sake. Now if I fight you and kill you, I'm killing you for my ego's sake. And Islam doesn't teach us that. To do something for our egos, to stab the people in their backs for their egos, for their benefit. Islam doesn't teach us to take benefit of Islam, to take benefit of tariqah, to take benefit and advantage of the shaykh, or advantage of the murid, or advantage of Quran, or advantage of anything. At that moment, he said, "Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah." He entered Islam. So after that incident, Prophet called Sayyidina Ali and said, "Ya Ali, look at me from my belly up." And he looked, Sayyidina Ali, everything disappeared, and he saw Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam everywhere, and his neck reaching the throne. Above, where is his head? He was not seeing. That is the أنا مدينة العلم وعلي بابه. I am the city of knowledge and Ali is the door. That is Naqshbandi, where I am coming to explain how much we are lucky. And then he said, look at my belly, and down he looked and he saw everything disappeared. The seven earths disappeared, and Sayyidina Ali's prophet knees, he cannot see where are his legs. He saw only to his knees under the seven earth. Then he said to him, look at me at all, completely. He saw the universe disappeared, the galaxies disappeared, the stars disappeared. The six, today they discovered there is 6 billion galaxies. They disappeared. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's what we are taking from that part. That kind of secrets and enlightenment. From Sayyidina Abu Bakr's side, it is said that whatever Prophet he said that Prophet has poured in my heart, ما صبه الله في ما صبه الله في صدره. لا. ما صبه الله في صدري صببته في صدر أبي بكر الصديق. Whatever Allah has put in my heart, I put in the heart of Sayyidina Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. It is said that this, what Prophet has put in, what Allah has put in his heart, he put in the heart of Abu Bakr al-Siddiq. That's why he was his second. إِذْ يَقُولُ لِصَاحِبِهِ لَا تَحْزَنْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَنَا. He's saying to his friend, don't worry, Allah is with us. Don't worry of what? Of these enemies that they are coming. Allah cannot protect his prophet. Why? Enemy can harm the prophet? No. Means, don't worry about the Ummah, Abu Bakr. What Allah opened to Prophet, and Prophet opened to Sayyidina Abu Bakr in that cave, Gharu Hira, when they were migrating to Medina, he's telling him, don't worry about the Ummah. Don't cry about them. In Allah ma'ana, Allah with us, means Allah with us, through my intercession, my shafa'ah, I will take them all to paradise. They are my Ummah.
Allah.
So we are coming from these two sides, to Sayyidina Ja'far al-Sadiq and all the way to Grand Sheikh Sheikh Abdullah Dawastani, to Mawlana Sheikh Muhammad Nazim al-Haqqani. May Allah bless him and give him long life. So, a father has many children. How much the father will be sad when he sees his children are fighting with each other? Is that? How many children do you have? Four or five?
Five
boys. All of them, mashallah, I was seeing them singing, praising Prophet. If you see them, You see, one of them went astray. Or he was trying to cheat his brothers. What you happy with, what will happen with you? You'll be sad, isn't it? Very sad. And the Sheikh, all his murid's followers are his children. He wants them to be together. He wants them to be one hand. He wants them to be one unity. He doesn't want the wealth of dunya to separate them. He doesn't want the material issues to make them to fight. Because it is not the message of Islam. Prophet ﷺ came to build the akhirah, not dunya. Awliya Allah, the saints, that Allah gave them that power, inheritance from Prophet to build the akhirah for their fellow. I know one person here, I will not mention his name. When I was thinking about the story of Sayyidina Ali and his neck is going up to that, cannot be seen, his neck was seen to this road. There is one of your friends here that he can see too much of that. Allah opened his heart. And you look at him, you see him forward. But his heart is so open, and he's sitting at the back. He's a trying to hide. There are many people between Allah, between Muris of the Sheikh, that Allah gave them that mushahada, that vision. Those who are blind, وَمَنْ كَانَ فِي هَذِهِ أَعْمَى فَهُوَ فِي الْآخِرَةِ أَعْمَى وَأَضَلُّ سَبِيلًا. Who is blind in dunya, is going to be blind in akhira and more as going astray. Means he is blind to see the power of the shaykh. His only concern is the benefit and the wealth of dunya. Nothing else. So his whole intention, or her, if it is a man or a woman, her intention, all her intention, or his whole intention, is money. How to make money? Nothing else. People are like that today. And Allah described the Wahhabis similarly to those who are in our tariqahs. As I said before, there is 41 tariqahs. And from out of 41 tariqahs, you think there is 41 only, there are thousands of branches. Like Naqshbandi tariqah. How many branches of Naqshbandi? I go to every country, there are Naqshbandis. They don't follow Sheikh Nazim. But we bring them. We try to get them to Mawlana Sheikh Nazim. Guide them, because they heard about the tariqah, they like it. But they say they are Naqshbandi, their sheikhs died, we bring them to Mawlana Sheikh. But there are thousands of branches around the world of Naqshbandi, as many others. So many between different tariqahs, not only one tariqah, between different tariqahs and common people, they are using the name of tariqah for benefit, for only their own interest and their own benefit. They do not care about Islam. I know some people in America, when I speak with them, some lobbyists, for Muslim lobbyists. When I say to them, what's going on with you? This is not Islamic. They say, we don't care about Islam. We only lobby for Muslim. Means we do money. Our job, if that Muslim has a problem, we solve his problem, we take money. They don't pray, they don't fast, they drink, they do everything. So their heart is not Islam. Their heart is what? What? What?
Money.
They made everything to fall apart for their own benefit, for all their own money. They don't care. This is their intention. Look, Maulana Sheikh, may Allah bless him. How much he suffered. I know him 48 years. But I know about his background also, that for more than 62 years he is suffering, running around the world. When he first came to England, there was no mosque. 1974 or 73. I think it was 1973. When Grand Sheikh died, after Grand Sheikh died by 6 months, 1974 came. Because Grand Sheikh died in October 1973, Maulana Sheikh Nazim came 1974. And Maulana Sheikh Nazim was not supposed to come to London. I was supposed to accompany my cousin because he has an eye problem. And the day I was going to with my cousin to get the tickets for next day to fly to London to fix his eye, he has an operation. That day, Maulana Sheikh Nazim coming from Damascus to Lebanon to visit his daughter, to visit me. And he said, where you are going packing? I said, I'm going to London. He said, did you buy the ticket? I said, I'm going now to go buy the ticket with my cousin. Like, my cousin at the stairs, we are going. And he entered. He said, no, drop your ticket, I will go. Maulana never went to London. Never was the intention in time of Grand Sheikh. But Grand Sheikh used to say, subhanallah, I still remember, he used to say when I was all these years with him, he used to say, I am seeing Sheikh Nazim in London. In 1974, that day I changed my tickets that was supposed to come to London and gave it to Maulana Sheikh, and he came with my cousin, and that was the first time he came to London, 1974. 1974, he came here, he was doing lecture in the park. There was no place to make lecture. There was no place to host him. So he was doing nasiha in one of the park, I don't know where. Maulana told me. And many people were coming, especially British, were coming and listening to Maulana Sheikh Nazim. You recall, you know these things? Anyone knows these things? No. That's why don't say, I speak with Sheikh Nazim, I know what Sheikh Nazim says. Many people on behalf of Maulana Sheikh now, they speak as if they are his spokesman. How many of them there are? Might be all of us. Everyone. He first get that Green Lane house. Till he had that place till the 80s, I think it was. Then he came to Jeddah. Before that they were trying to buy Shakwal Lane Mosque. So he established Green Lane. He established Shakwal Lane Mosque. He established Peckham Mosque. Then in 1990 he established the Priory. And he gave up everything for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Isn't that? He took anything? And now for 5 years he didn't come back. And what was his intention is Allah and his Prophet. It's not a building. He left the building in good hands. In Hajj Jawdat hands, in the other people, if we are speaking about Peckham Mosque. And he left. He didn't take anything with him. He is sitting in Cyprus since 2000. our duty is if really we love our Sheikh, we do for what he taught us to do, that build your akhir, not build your dunya. You want to build your dunya, build it, it's no problem. اللهم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. Oh Allah, give us in dunya حسنة, good wealth, and in آخرة. But not on behalf of Islam, not on behalf of the Muslims, by hijacking their voices like the Wahhabis did, by hijacking their buildings that the Wahhabi did, by hijacking their voice like the Wahhabi did with their leader. Now we are seeing this going on also with the Sufis. We are seeing this going around along with the same followers of Sheikh Nasser. They are hijacking the voices. They are hijacking the buildings. Under the name of the name that they think that they are, what they are doing. And they are the spokesman on behalf of everyone and on behalf of the Sheikh. How many more in England has been hijacked by Wahhabi? Most of them. The innocent Turkish people, after 1 year is taken by Wahhabi. Innocent Pakistani, with the mosque, after 1 year taken by Wahhabi. Indian the same. Arab the same, Arab the same. Many like that is gone. Now this contamination is going through also other people and going through Sufi. Not letting anyone to speak, not letting anyone to say. And Allah described that in Surah Al-Mu'minun. All those who are from the same group who are doing this, Allah said, إِذَا جَاءَكَ الْمُنَافِقُونَ قَالُوا نَشْهَدُ إِنَّكَ لَرَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ إِنَّكَ لَرَسُولُ وَاللَّهُ يَشْهَدُ إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ. Listen, when the hypocrites come to you, Ya Muhammad, they say, remember that thou art indeed the messenger of Allah. These are the Wahhabis. These are the Wahhabis. Now we go to the next one, because we are our tariqah. We don't speak on other tariqahs. They come to Sheikh Nasser and they say, oh, we bear witness that you are our Sheikh. Is that? Sheikh Nasser is not a prophet. Sheikh Nasser is not a Sahabi. Sheikh Nasser is not, he is a wali that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given him, inherited him from Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whatever a prophet wants to give secret, he gave secret. أَلَا إِنَّ أَوْلِيَاءَ اللَّهِ لَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَهُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Verily, Allah's saints, they nothing to fear. مَنْ عَادَ لِي وَلِيًّا أَذَنْتُهُ بِالْحَرْبِ. Prophet said, whoever come against one of my wali, I declare war against him. Be careful. We don't want a war against us. We don't want to come against our Sheikh's wishes by stabbing him in the back because of some benefit that might be able to get here and there. We involve ourselves in stabbing the Sheikh in the back, we don't want. Then we will be under Allah's oath that He will declare war on us. We don't want that. And what Allah said, we bear witness that thou, you indeed the messenger of Allah, you are the messenger of Allah. And Allah knows that thou art indeed His messenger. And Allah knows that Sheikh Nasser is indeed is a wali. You are kazzab. You, the one, that one, or that group of people or those who are trying to come to Sheikh and say, you are our Sheikh, we bear witness, you are our Sheikh, Allah is saying to them, I don't need your witness. I witness that he is my saint. You are liars. You are getting benefit. You are trying to stab him in the back by getting benefit. By using name of Islam to do whatever you like for benefiting your wealth. And Allah bear witness that the hypocrites are indeed liars. Don't believe them. When they come to you and say, Sheikh Nazim said that to me to tell you, don't believe. Give me your evidence. Who said, who showed me that Sheikh Nazim has given authority for someone that can sit in his chair? Show me. Point to one. If Sheikh Nazim said to someone, do zikr, he doesn't mean that he can sit on his chair. He is the one that can sit on this throne, no one else. No one can speak on the tongue of the Sheikh. It's tarkul adab, it's against manners and discipline. I am afraid of myself, and you are afraid of yourself to say that we are speaking on behalf of the Sheikh. It's not, because we are full of ego. Sheikh has no ego. When we sit on the chair, we think ourselves kings. You know what happened to Grand Sheikh? Grand Sheikh, when Sheikh Sharafuddin was passing away, he wrote his will 3 days before he passed away. And in his will he says that my successor is Sheikh Abdullah Daghestani. And he wrote the will and gave it to Grand Sheikh, Sheikh Abdullah Daghestani, and said, after I die, you distribute this to everyone and show it to everyone. If someone gave to you and said to you, if he is a minister, and say to you, you are my deputy, what you do? You go call all the media around the world, say, I am the deputy of that minister. Because you are happy, you are proud. You want to everyone to know that you are the deputy. Grand Sheikh has been given the Khilafah, means carrying the whole Naqshbandi on his head shoulders around the world, because he carried the great secrets, Sirr al-Azam, from Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Our branch is the Haqqani branch that carry the great secret of the Naqshbandi, the whole Naqshbandi order. All the rest are branches, we are the trunk. From that trunk is everything coming. And that's why Naqshbandi does not accept tyranny in it. There is no way for tyranny to enter in it. And this year, beginning of this year, Muharram, the year that tyranny is going to fall down and Haq going to come up, first between Naqshbandis. To clean first the group that are waiting and waiting and waiting for Mahdi alayhi salam. If they are not clean, what they are waiting for? That group has to be clean first. Not this one that I'm speaking to 500 or 300 years. No. Around the world. Naqshbandis is around the world now today. In Indonesia alone, we have millions.
SubhanAllah.
So Grand Sheikh, what he did? As soon as Sheikh Sharafuddin passed away, when he passed away, when they were washing him, he made his hand like that. He was dead, but his hand was like that, like a cup. So the water was coming in, and everyone was drinking. Then when finished, his hand went down. They are alive. As soon as everyone went, Grand Sheikh took the well, tear it apart and throw it, and burn it. He said, I don't want anyone to know. I'm not after Khilafah. I'm getting it from Allah. I'm not interested getting it from people. Who wants to come, welcome. Who doesn't want to come, I don't care. If it was for us, what we will do? Allahu Akbar. We will not sit on this chair and not on this member. You know there is a big high spike. We sit on it, even we are hurt, we sit on it and say, we are the Khalifa. We are calling Sheikh Nazim, we are speaking with Sheikh Nazim, this is the message from Sheikh Nazim, he wants to do that, he wants to do that, he wants to do this, and everyone else, close your tongue, don't speak, close your mouth, we don't want to hear you, I am the one representing Sheikh here. That's our problem. Correct? When Grand Sheikh was passing away, before 1 week, he wrote his will. And he said, I'm passing away after 1 week. And after 1 week, which was Sunday. Means next Sunday, I'm passing away. And he died on Sunday. He wrote in his will that whatever Prophet ﷺ has blessed me of Khilafah, and all my Grand Sheikh has blessed me, Grand Sheikh said, what Prophet has blessed me and Sheikh Sharafuddin has blessed me, I dress Sheikh Nazim with that.
Subhanallah.
He wrote some names, I'm not mentioning these names, and then he said, this is the will, make it two copies. We made it two copies. And he took his, thumb, and he stamped it. And he said, one of them, put it in my grave. When I come in the grave, when Ankar wa Nakir comes, I will show it. This is my will, what I have been, what I have got in dunya of wealth, what I did with it. Because in the will he said, what is... how much he gives this one, how much he gives that one, how much he gives his wife, how much he gives his daughter. Everything was there. And then he said, Sheikh Hisham and Sheikh Adnan, I am giving you these things to keep for Mahdi alayhi salam when he comes to deliver him in his hand. That was in the way. Maulana Sheikh Nazim was in Cyprus. And still today, I have that amana from Grand Sheikh, as he said, to be given to Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam, and my brother has the other half to give it to Sayyidina al-Mahdi alayhi salam. We hope that all of us, we see Mahdi inshallah alayhi salam. Till today, it's with us. Then, he said, these two copies, one copy in my grave, one copy, you give it to Sheikh Nazim. And Grand Sheikh passed out after 1 week, as he said, and I'm not going into the details of that. And then Maulana Sheikh Nazim, we cannot reach him, he is in Cyprus. There was no telephone like today. And it is a long story. Suddenly he came, he appeared. He came from Cyprus. How he got the message, we don't know. We know that he appeared at the door, someone came out of the blue, said, no, don't bury Grand Sheikh, Sheikh Nazim is arriving in 2 hours. Wow. All these ulama, might be 100,000 alim and people were in the janazah of Grand Sheikh. So I was young and my brother was young, so we refused to bury Grand Sheikh because that man said the Grand Sheikh is coming, Maulana Sheikh Nazim is coming. All these ulama wants to bury, we said no, we have two kids. They said, oh, these are crazy, leave them. So they went, we finished, and Maulana Sheikh Nazim arrived, was Ramadan, 4th of Ramadan, he arrived at Maghrib time. We took Grand Sheikh from the coffin and we buried him. And then Maulana Sheikh Nazim said, go and eat. And we went and we left. So we put one will in the grave, and the other will, after we buried Grand Sheikh, that night Sheikh Nazim slept in Damascus. Next day he went to Beirut, to our home. And we put that will, we showed it to Grand Maulana Sheikh Nazim, and he said, put it in the safe box. We had a huge safe box that I still remember today. I put it on the upper level of the safe box. And you know the old safe box, they are very heavy. And the lock and the key is like this. So locked it very well, put the will inside. That Grand Sheikh has given the authority to Maulana Sheikh Nazim. And then Maulana Sheikh Nazim, next day, he said, I'm going to Cyprus back. My job is finished now. And we went to get the will to give to him. He said, no need, I don't want it. We said, what we will do with it? You keep it? He said, no, you keep it. And he said, and we said, no, we are not going to keep it. We are worried that it will be lost. He said, okay, since you are worried to be lost, go get it to me. We went to the box, safe box. We opened. It's a huge safe box, like this mihrab. It's my father's one. Open it, and there was no will. It disappeared. Where it's gone, Allah knows. So no one knew. Except one person who was, two people who were there in that will. One of them did not agree on Maulana Sheikh Nazim's appointment. After a while he died. And another one, he didn't agree of Maulana Sheikh Nazim's appointment, he went crazy. That one crazy still living in Damascus. The one who didn't agree, he died, he's finished a long time ago. So I'm saying this, that in order that the Sheikh, no one can say, I am close to the Sheikh, I can say this, I can say that, I can say this, I can listen to me, hear to me, I can do this. And not only that, benefiting, trying to benefit of whatever his hand can reach. That's the problem. That's the problem. We must not try to use the Sheikh's teachings or the Sheikh's nearness to the Sheikh in order to benefit for ourselves and to build ourselves. If Allah sent, Alhamdulillah. But not to use it as a vehicle to get the utmost of everything. And that's why Allah didn't like and describe such people in Surah Al-Munafiqun, where he say now, they have made their oath a screen for their misdeeds. They come to you, they say, oh, wallah, Sheikh Nazim told me to do this. No? Sheikh Nazim asked me for you to do this, to listen to me. To do this for me, to do that for me, to sign this for me, to write this for me, to carry me by your car, to give me a book, to give me anything you can imagine. Allah is saying, they have made their oath a screen, thus they obstruct man from the path of Allah, truly evil are their deeds. That's the problem. I know many people are not like that. Most of them, Alhamdulillah, all of them. But we are trying to explain something that is becoming a problem in the community, in the Muslim community and the Sufi community. That is because they believed, then they rejected faith. That's why ثم آمنوا ثم كفروا ثم آمنوا ثم كفروا. One day they are believer, one day they are unbeliever. Because you do something wrong. It's not unbeliever that you deny Islam, no. This means here that one day you do something okay, the next day you go against it. One day you do something for the benefit of the community, next day you stab them in the back, you do something for your own benefit. Look, this mosque, from its beginning to its end, it is a mosque. It was used a mosque. The work, what that big mosque here you have in London? Regent's Park, Regent's Park. Regent's Park. It's a mosque from its beginning. Is not? Shaqwa Lane Mosque is a mosque from its beginning. Mosque has to be mosque from the beginning till the end, cannot be other than mosque. Can be an institution for teaching Islam, yes? This mosque can teach Islam. But nothing else. So mosque has to be for what it has meant it to be. Nothing else. You cannot do something that is a mosque and next day you turn it into something else. It's impossible. Either it is a mosque or not a mosque. So you decide from day one. Because it is mentioned that mosque, that's why masjid or al-jami' cannot be sold. when you enter in a mosque, when there are rented places that they use them mosques, when you enter into them, what you do? First thing you want to do, what you do? What you pray? That's wrong. Because that is a rented place. Means one day you are going to lose it. The only tahiyyat in masjid, according to the fourth school of thought, is only for a masjid that it was built as a masjid, bought as a masjid, and still till judgment day be as a masjid, that's where you can pray tahiyyatul masjid. Nothing else. No more else. That is a sunnah wajiba. For a rented mosque, or a mosque that you think that you one day try to sell it, that it is not a mosque anymore. It is a business. You cannot. And then you don't need to pray tahiyyat al-masjid in that place because it's not acceptable. It's not wajib. It's not nafil wajib. But this mosque is always a mosque. You can do that. So there are very technical things people don't know about. You cannot come and say, oh, this is a mosque and I want to do this here, this, and that's here, that, and that's here, that's sometimes is not an Islamic mosque, is a mosque. Did you see a church ever being turned into a disco? Huh? Yes. No. Yes. You saw?
Yes.
After the church. They sold it. Yes. But did you see a church in it, a disco?
No.
No. But after they sell it, you do whatever you like to do. But a masjid, can you sell it to become a disco?
No.
Hush! That's why you don't see mosque being sold or being used. And that what Allah said, and I will end because I know all of you are busy. He said, وإذا رأيتهم تعجبك أجسامهم. When you look at them, their exteriors please you. Because they are like sales marketing managers. They know how to speak. You know, they take courses in universities to teach you how to speak in order to convince people that what you are saying is correct. And Allah said, when you look at them, you look at their exterior, they please you. And when they speak, thou listen to their words, you listen to them. Because you think that they are saying something important, something. Ah, Sheikh Nazim said this. When you, everyone say, if someone come to me and say, Sheikh Nazim said to you to this, I feel obliged to say yes. I'm worried to say no. They are using the shuyukh in order to implement their agendas. That is a danger. They are as worthless as hollow, Allah said. They are pieces of timber propped up. كأنهم خشب مسنن. They are pieces of timber propped up. Propped up. Unable to stand on their own. Because when they are going to stand on their own, they fall down, they all fall apart, they have nothing. But because they used Islam and stabbed the Sheikh in his back, they become, they have something to stand on it. There are many who do that. Not in Naqshbandi, in Qadiri, in Rufai, in Shisti, in between common Muslims, between everyone. Today they are doing this. So beware of them, they are the enemies. And I will conclude with that. Beware of them, they are the enemies. The curse of Allah be on them. How are they deluded away from the truth? May Allah forgive us, all of us. And keep us on the right way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to His Prophet. And to keep the love of our Shaykh in our heart. And try to be as much as we can, all of us, obedient servant to Allah, obedient servant to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and follow the footsteps of our Shaykh. And not to use Islam or Muslims for our own benefits. If we need to have a benefit, let us do it by our cleverness outside of using Islam and Muslims. Using our expertise to do something that we benefit out and help Muslims and Islam. Not using what Muslims and Islam owns, using what they own in order to make what we want to make of benefit and wealth. No. Let us make benefit and wealth from something else and come and give it and donate it to Muslims and Islam. ومن الله التوفيق بحرمة الفاتحة.